So now, one of the stars of Hitchcock. I'm so excited here. One of the great actresses today.
Oh, you're lovely.
Toni Collette.
Hello, how are you? I'm fine, thank you.
The Academy Award nominee, Emmy, Golden Globe winner, and here you are playing this woman who I knew quite a bit about.
Really?
But
you
public,
did?
Yeah, I'm a Hitchcock nut, so.
Okay.
Let's talk about Peggy Robertson and give her some cred.
Yeah, well, you know, that's the one thing I love about this movie. It kind of examines the relationships that Hitchcock has with the women in his world.
And they're all around him.
Yeah, and, you know, there was one thing to be said for this kind of, and it's kind of a notion that people are familiar with, you know, that this kind of domineering, controlling, obsessive director with his leading ladies. But there were two women in his life, one of which was my character in the movie, Peggy Robertson, and obviously his wife, Alma Revel, who were
Helen
very
Barron,
different.
Yes.
Yeah, Helen's incredible in the movie.
And, how were they different, Toni?
Well, actually, Peggy's like a mini Alma. I guess the relationship isn't as intimate. Peggy, I'm told, firsthand from Hitchcock's script supervisor, that he could not get anything done without Peggy Robertson. So not only was she a very organized, anal kind of keeper of the records, but she knew the man inside out,
and she was British,
and she accepted him, and yeah, she came to Hollywood and she worked with him for almost four decades, and she was just a very grounded, strong, capable human being who wouldn't take any crap from him, and I think that's why it lasted so long.
And I've seen it twice now, the movie, which I just loved it.
I'm so jealous, I haven't seen it once.
Oh, you haven't seen it once? Well, you're in it a lot. All the way through.
I know that I have a small part, but I didn't care. I just loved it so much. I love that it's set in this exquisite looking period, the 50s. It's just so beautiful, and in this golden era of filmmaking and Hollywood and being able to shoot at Paramount, I still get a kick out of going on that lot. And but ultimately, I think I just loved that it was time for Alma Revel to be celebrated.
I agree with you completely.
She was very much his partner and a very silent partner. She never took any credit, but she was such a talented woman in her own right.
She edited, and she was she was his boss, as it brings out.
I know. Yeah.
His daughter Patricia is still alive. Did she have anything to do with? Did she have any say? Did she have any input? Because she's not depicted in the movie at all.
No, she'd written a book,
and Helen
keeps saying this. It's very interesting that their only child chose to write a book, not about the famous father, but about Alma Revel. And
she loved her mother.
Yeah.
She's very much like her mother. Those of you who are obsessed, you can go on YouTube and Patricia Hitchcock, you'll see her, and she was little and tiny, and she was in Strangers on a Train.
Yeah. But Alma was just, she's quite bird-like, under 5 feet, I think.
And Helen is
physically she wasn't the same, but I think, you know, she really captured the essence of Alma.
Yes, I think she did, yes, absolutely, because she's, like, there, she's capable, she's, every moment, she's, like, there for him, no matter what, and, I just love the fact that I'm talking to Peggy Robertson. I never thought I'd ever get the chance. Toni Collette, who's played so many roles in so many wonderful movies and on TV in
I've
the
been
United
very lucky,
States
yeah.
of Tara. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm a playwright someday. Who knows? Maybe we'll work together.
Cool.
Write great parts for women. I said it.
Okay.
Plugging myself and plugging Hitchcock, one of the best films of the year.
Oh, good to
Thank
hear.
Thank you so much,
Thank you.
Toni
love
Collette.
To meet you.
Bye-bye.